My name is Todd Mark. I'm the medical assistant here at Reynolds. We're going to go over anaphylaxis today.
What is anaphylaxis? Everybody wants to know.
Good question.
Okay. Anaphylaxis is a severe, life-threatening, potential allergic reaction. It can happen basically when you're exposed to an allergen that your body doesn't like. Specifically, for example, bee stings, wasp stings, peanuts. And for us here in Jacksonville, it's probably going to be wasps and bees,
yep.
Especially this time of the year.
Yeah, when the temperatures get around 50 degrees, the yellow jacket wasps get very, very agitated. So anaphylaxis can lead to anaphylactic shock. What's anaphylactic shock? Well, it's when your body goes into shock and your blood pressure suddenly drops and your airways narrow, possibly blocking normal breathing. And sometimes this can happen very rapidly. Annually, there are about 60 deaths worldwide from bee stings due to anaphylactic shock.
So what are some of the symptoms of anaphylaxis? Feeling lightheaded, dizziness, feeling faint.
Yeah, difficulty breathing or swallowing, or like they'll be doing like this.
Right, and then you also may hear what we call wheezing, which is a narrowing of the airway. You'll hear like a high-pitched sound coming out of their mouth.
Yep, fast heart rate.
Clammy, cool, moist, diaphoretic skin is another symptom you may see too.
Yep, and going along with any type of shock, confusion, anxiety. Sometimes they'll have a feeling of impending doom, or they'll get that fight or flight.
You probably know your coworkers pretty well. You work with them side by side every day. You're gonna notice, hey, this person, they're not acting like their normal self. Another symptom you may see, which is life-threatening, potential fatal, is they collapse or they lose consciousness.
Yeah, that's not a good thing if they fall down and they're not breathing anymore. Okay.
So, how do we treat anaphylaxis? The first thing that we wanna do is we wanna make sure the scene is safe. You don't want to become the victim in this situation.
Yeah, make sure the bees are gone before you go jumping
right in there. Exactly.
Phone or, and sometimes if this is going to be shown in other plants, you know, make sure you check your PEO manual, whatever, but phone or ask someone to phone 911. That's really the first thing you need to do. You need to get emergency services on the way. Activate the PEO alarm so you can get help immediately there. First aid kit and AED is what you need too.
Right. And if you're the one who's gonna treat the employee you're with them, you send somebody else to get this, get the AED, pull the PEO alarm. If you are with the person who's having problems, have them lay down, lay on the floor, it doesn't matter, they just need to lay down somewhere.
Now, usually people who have severe anaphylaxis from bee stings, they will have their own EpiPens, however, they are $900 to $1,000,
right,
$500 with insurance. So they may not.
We hope that, and most people who do have severe anaphylaxis to bees or certain allergens carry their EpiPen with them. So the first thing you want to do is ensure that that is their pen and that it's not expired. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to take the safety cap off of the EpiPen. It's pretty easy. This is a safety cap, blue to the sky, orange to the thigh. You're gonna hold the EpiPen in your fist, you're going to find your landmarks. Your landmarks are, let me show you. So between your hip and your knee, you're going to go right in the middle. You can't go wrong. Boom. Right here, you're going to press down. You're going to hear a click, and you're going to hold for 10 seconds. And they don't do that. Only Todd does that.
All right, so
after you take this off, you want to ensure that it makes it into a sharps container, but we won't worry about that right now.
Yeah, well, you just put it somewhere, we'll take care of it, bring it in here. You know, see if the person needs CPR, if they need CPR, why, you know, give the CPR. If you don't know how to do CPR, at least give chest compressions. The worst thing that you can do is stand there and do nothing.
Right, and you know, you're going to know if they need CPR, they're not breathing, they don't have a pulse. You can feel a carotid pulse here. I know this is a little out of our topic, but, or a radial pulse. Like Todd said, you're not going to go wrong initiating chest compressions. Believe me, they're going to tell you if they're going to wake up and say that hurts. Mm-hmm. You start doing chest compressions.
Yep. Make sure you stay with them. Things can go downhill in a hurry. And if you're using the EpiPen, put the AED on.
Right. And also, make sure someone's gone to get the oxygen tanks. We've gone over this in another video. You're not going to go wrong putting a nasal cannula on them or a non-rebreather just for assistance.
All right. Ready to do this in real time?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Oh, I got stung by a bee, Marcy, and I'm severely allergic to them.
Oh my God, so you lay down right here.
I'm going to pass out right about here. Oh, I'm having troubles breathing.
Is this your EpiPen, Todd?
It is. Is that my name on it?
It is. Is it within date? It's not expired, right?
No, it is. It is not.
Okay. So the blue cap would have been on, blue to the sky. I'm going to pull the cap out. I'm going to find my landmarks. Boom. 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10. Take it out. Todd, how are you feeling?
Woo! I feel so much better, Marcy. Thank you.
Saved the day.
Wow.
And that's basically it, guys. Obviously, they're probably not going to bounce back like that. They're going to lay there. You're going to wait for 911, and they're going to reassess and evaluate the situation and make sure the employee is good to go. More than likely, they're probably going to be transported to the local emergency department.
Yeah. All right. So let's wrap this up. Make sure the scene is safe. Don't make yourself a victim.
If you are a PEO member and you don't feel comfortable doing this, that's totally fine, but you need to pass your task off to somebody else and tell somebody else what to do.
Absolutely. You know, I had all the fire scenes when I was an officer on the fire department. Best thing I can have sometimes is gophers.
Right. And last but not least, we have these EPI trainers here in medical. We'll be glad if you're feeling a little uncomfortable about this, come in. We'll show you how to use it. It's very, very simple. And the more you do something, the more comfortable you're going to become with doing this.
Yeah. Remember, the worst thing that you can do is stand there and do nothing. So if you have any questions, we're at extension 1105 here in Jacksonville. Come down here. You can play with that EPI trainer, whatever. We'll show you anything that you want. Okay? Until then,
be safe.
Be safe.
Thank you.
Well, goodbye. And don't think it hasn't been a little slice of heaven, because it hasn't.